पधारो मारे।
द वेलकमिंग वर्ड पधारो मारो देश, विच मीन्स कम विजिट अवर कंट्री, brightens up the face of each tourist traveling to Rajasthan. Namaste from Team Me Flying Bird. Welcome to the Pink City, Jaipur. From my travel series, #MFBTravels. In this video, I'm going to tell you the top places to visit and the things to do in Jaipur. Before we get started, don't forget to click on the red subscribe button on the bottom right corner of the screen and click on the bell button so that you don't miss any future video uploads. And follow me on Instagram. Thanks for subscribing and following. Now let's begin. We boarded Shatabdi train in the morning from New Delhi Railway Station, which departs at 6 a.m. and reaches at 10:50 a.m. at Jaipur. Quickly, we moved to our hotel, and since time was less, so we have not wasted time in taking rest and quickly moved outside to visit the places. First, we moved to the beautiful Nahargarh Fort. Nahargarh Fort stands on the edge of the Aravalli Hills, built in the year 1734 by Maharaja Sawai Jai Singh, the King of Jaipur. So we are at the beautiful Nahargarh Fort, which is among one of the biggest fort in Rajasthan. Now let's move inside. There's a beautiful story that how Nahargarh Fort actually got its name. When the construction actually started, the worker every day found some disturbing strange activities, and every morning they found the construction they had built on the previous night was somehow all destroyed. Later, they found that the fort was previously owned by some Rathore prince named Nahar Singh, and this is how the fort got his name as Nahargarh Fort. Here is the ticket charts, and the prices are quite reasonable. Moving on to the main palace of the fort, apparently the king have 9 wives, and these were the main apartments, which look quite similar to each other. And the most interesting part is that he would just come in here and they would know whose apartment he is going to. Now, this is that long corridor which actually the king assists to visit his wife's apartments. Let's go to the terrace of the palace now, which is the most interesting and most beautiful part of the fort, where you can see all the domes from all the corners, and don't miss out the amazing view of the city. Especially, don't miss out the sunset. It's like unforgettable view. Moving on to the next part of the fort, which is the stepwell, where the palace used to reserve the rainwater, which apparently the only source of water used by the whole kingdom.
अब आप देख पा रहे हैं जल महल मेरे पीछे। मैं अभी हमें तो थोड़ा सा वक्त लग गया यहाँ में पहुँचते, और इसमें जल महल में एक कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, ये सुबह से लेके रात तक ये हमेशा खुली रहती है। पर अब जो मेन जो आप देख रहे हो महल जो है नदी के बीच में, उस पर आप जा नहीं सकते हो, इट्स नॉट अलाउड टू गो देयर। सो यहाँ में शाम का माहौल जो है ये बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग है, जैसे कि आप देख पा रहे हो, जैसे यहाँ में वेंडर्स है जो छोटे मोटे सामान, खिलौने और काफ़ी कुछ बेच रहे हैं, और यहाँ में शाम का जो सिंपल वॉकिंग और फ्रेंड्स के साथ आप घूमने के लिए, और टूरिस्ट भी यहाँ में बहुत अच्छा टाइम स्पेंड कर रहे हैं। चलिए मैं आपको दिखाती हूँ जल महल का थोड़ा सा स्ट्रीट शॉपिंग कैसा है। ये वेंडर्स छोटे मोटे कुछ कुछ सामान जो है वो बेचते हैं। चलिए दिखाती हूँ। वो सब कितने का है दीदी?
180 का
पेयर। हाँ 180 का पेयर,
10 रुपए का।
सारे ये होम डेकोर्स आइटम है, और ये गणेशा का जो ये है आइडल है 450। किसका है ये? पीपल का है। और आप मेरे पीछे जो वो लाइट जल रही है आप देख पा रहे हैं, वो है जल महल। बहुत ही ब्यूटीफुल लग रहा है, इसमें लाइट जल रहा है, पर वहाँ जा पाने से ज़्यादा अच्छा लगता था, पर वेरी सैड कि हम वहाँ में जा नहीं सकते, तो मैं बस बाहर खड़े होके ही एंजॉय कर रही हूँ जल महल को। हवा महल ऑफ जयपुर।
राइट नाउ वी आर स्टैंडिंग आउटसाइड द आइकॉनिक हवा महल। यू कैन इवन गो इनसाइड द महल। प्राइस इज ₹10 फॉर इंडियंस एंड 50 फॉर फॉरेनर्स। वेल द हवा महल विच इज बिल्ट फेसिंग विद लॉट्स ऑफ स्मॉल विंडोज फेसिंग द मेन रोड विच वॉज बिल्ट सो दैट द वुमेन ऑफ द रॉयल फैमिली could enjoy the festivities of the cities without going outside. Hi friends, it's day 3 and right now I'm standing here just in front of the city palace, as you can see, and it is the one of the main attraction in the Jaipur. So this palace is built in the year 1729 by Raja Sawai Man Singh. So let's go inside and check it out first there. Beautiful city palace was built in the year 1729 to 1732. It's still the residence of the royal family, so not accessible entirely. The architecture style of the palace is a mix of Hindu Rajput, Mughal and European style. The palace is designed completely as per the Vastu Sastra. now we are at our last destination from Jaipur tour, and that is the beautiful Amer Fort.
Look at the beautiful Amer Fort behind me.
So Amer Fort, or in English we call it as Amber Fort, was built by Raja Man Singh, who was also Akbar's one of the Navratna. And don't miss out the great view from the top of the palace. Friends, this is called Diwani Am, where all his subjects would come and approach him, and here the place is simply spectacular. You can even bring away your home these beautiful antique pieces from Amer Fort. Now, this is the spectacular Sheesh Mahal. The story behind the spectacular Sheesh Mahal is actually the queen loved to sleep under the stars, but the kingdom won't let her to sleep outdoors, so the king bring on the architect to build it, cause when you see the ceiling it feels like you are sleeping under the stars. So wow, that's true love. So this is the end of our today's episode. Hope you have liked this one. Then give it a thumbs up and comment below if you have any suggestion or which part of the video you liked the most. And make sure you subscribe. See you guys.